The name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today we celebrate the feast of St. Catherine of Siena, Virgin, Lay Dominican, and Doctor of the Church. So let us call to mind our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who set St. Catherine of Siena on fire with divine love, in her contemplation of the Lord's Passion and her service of your Church, grant through her intercession that your people, participating in the mystery of Christ, may ever exalt in the revelation of his glory, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from Acts of the Apostles. There broke out a severe persecution of the church in Jerusalem, and all were scattered throughout the countryside of Judea and Samaria, except the apostles. Devout men buried Stephen and made a loud lament over him. Saul, meanwhile, was trying to destroy the church. Entering house after house and dragging out men and women, he handed them over for imprisonment. Now those who had been scattered went about preaching the word. Thus Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed and crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Shout joyfully to God, all the earth. Sing praise to the glory of his name. Proclaim his glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous are your deeds.
Let all
the
earth
cry out to God with joy. Let all on earth worship and sing praise to you, sing praise to your name. Come and see the works of God, his tremendous deeds among the children of Adam. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. He has changed the sea into dry land. Through the river they passed on foot. Therefore let us rejoice in him. He rules by his might forever. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Everyone who believes in the Son has eternal life. and I shall raise him on the last day, says the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowd, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. But I told you that although you have seen me, you do not believe. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day. The Gospel of the Lord. Good morning. Seems like there, in our own lives, there seems to be some saints who really intercede for us. In particular, those are saints that we might really love and we constantly ask for that intercession. But there are some saints that really click together with us. Individuals have different favorites, of course. But Saint Catherine of Siena seems to have interceded for me in different ways. I was visiting Siena. I was living in Rome at that time, but visiting Siena, and there's a little chapel dedicated to her life, and it's basically where she grew up, her old house. They made a little chapel there. I remember praying there, and during that time, I couldn't really make that leap in order to, you know, join the Dominicans. I knew that I had a call to be a Dominican and to be a priest, but I just couldn't make that leap during that time. Praying there, about an hour or two, I remember, everything just kind of became really clear, crystal clear, after that incident of praying there for about an hour or two. And she made it really clear for me during that time in order for me to make that leap. So I remember calling the vocation director perhaps the week after, spending time with Catherine in her old house. Saints in different ways have that kind of power to lead us closer to Christ and to lead us to a further strengthening of our vocations. And Catherine certainly has that power which comes from Christ in order for her to really intercede for us and to pray for us, and for us to, through that intercession, get closer to Christ. And as the Gospels relate to us today, I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. This is Christ speaking, and he's willing to suffer so that he can do the will of the Father. So there is that kind of perfect obedience that he has to the Father, and it is that obedient submission to the Father's will that he is able to bring forth all the goods in the world. And Catherine of Siena certainly followed after Christ and was able to really go after the will of her Savior, Jesus Christ. The story is that she was so profoundly in love with Christ that some of the memories of her confers, especially in the hospitals, can be kind of shocking when we actually hear it. One story is that she was so profoundly in love with Christ that she wanted to mortify herself to the point where she felt the suffering Christ in her own life. So one incident, she actually goes to a sick person, a very sick person who has pus all over her body, and she actually
sucks the pus out of her body in order to feel the mortification, in order to feel the suffering Christ in her own life. I don't particularly advise that for you to practice that in today's world, but it just shows us that when we are in love with Christ, when we are truly in love with Christ, we can do certain things that go beyond the ordinary. And Catherine of Siena certainly shows us that. So perhaps what the Gospels relate to us, I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. How does that look like in your own life? How does that look like in my life? To do the will of the Father. Something to think about today.
With the intercession of St. Catherine of Siena, we offer up our prayers to our Heavenly Father. We pray for the Church, for the unity in the Church, that she may always be guided by the Holy Spirit, and she may always be strengthened, and that her members will always know the will of the Father. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are doing what they can to fight this pandemic, this invisible enemy, that we may pray for the leaders of the leaders of the countries, that they may find solutions and resolutions to fight this pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of us that we may be strengthened and that we may always trust in the Lord, especially His divine providence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for those who are struggling, especially those who are homeless and those who have no food to eat. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for the prayers in the silence of our hearts. For these and for all the faithful departed, and we pray especially for the repose of the soul of Sarah Forbes, and for all healing of those with addictions. For whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear our prayers and answer them accordingly in your time, and grant us grace and hope. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Set
the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy Church. Accept, O Lord, the saving sacrifice we offer in commemoration of Saint Catherine, so that instructed by her teaching, we may give ever more fervent thanks to you, the one true God, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always, here, and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. We praise you in memory of the Holy Virgin and Dr. Catherine, to whom you gave the knowledge of the unsearchable mysteries of your life, and whom you inflamed with an ever greater love for your church. For she contemplated you in constant prayer, and ardently cried out for the restoration of unity out of discord. Ever obedient and humble, she begged the Church of Christ, mindful of her duty, to live always as a faithful bride of Christ, to be presented without spot or wrinkle at the end of time. And so with the Church and the whole company of angels and saints, we celebrate your glory with exultation, crying out with one voice, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body and one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Andrew, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. May the heavenly table at which we have been fed, O Lord, confer eternal life upon us, as even in this world it nourished the life of Saint Catherine, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Catherine of Siena was often referred to as the Reformer. She reformed the church. So as a lay Dominican, as a lay faithful, she was able to reform the church, and she was able to unify the church during a time when there were some divisions. One pope in Avignon, France, and another in Rome. And she was able to bring Gregory the 11th from France back to Rome. And she was able to reform the church, and she also reformed the state of the clergy, the sinfulness of the clergy, able to reform. So, as a lay faithful, you're given the authority of Christ at baptism, and those what is given to you at baptism is strengthened each day through prayer. And the Holy Spirit in baptism, baptismal grace each day. So with that strengthening, sometimes Christ gives you that way of reforming the church, the mission to reform the church. So I advise you to really seek that in your life and see what God is calling you to do. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.